Samuel Taylor Coleridge's poem, The Rime of the Ancient Mariner, is split into 7 parts. In the introduction, the mariner stops a young man on his way to a wedding and tells the tale of an ocean voyage. In the rising action, his ship gets blown off course and ends up at the South Pole, trapped in ice. When an albatross flies by, its presence seems to break the ice surrounding the ship. The crew sails away with the albatross following. The mariner then shoots the albatross for absolutely no reason. Believing the bird had brought favorable winds, the crew becomes angry, but change their tune because then they believe the bird brought a thick fog. The ship sails into strange waters, and then the wind ceases. Driven mad by terrible thirst, the men hang the dead albatross around the mariner's neck. The mariner spies a strange ghostly ship piloted by death and life in death. The two figures roll dice to see who will take the mariner's soul. Life and death wins the game. Death takes the lives of the crew, leaving the mariner the only live person on the ship. The mariner has no food or water, but still, he lives. He watches sea serpents swim in the water, blessing their presence. When the albatross breaks free from the mariner's neck, he is suddenly able to pray again. The mariner sleeps and wakes to find rain that he can drink. As a storm approaches, the ship sails on without any wind to propel it. In the climax of the poem, the bodies of the men are taken over by angels. The dead crew members help sail the ship. The ship is tossed about, and the mariner falls into a swoon where he hears two voices talking about him and the penance he must pay. The crew members continue to sail the ship until it appears in the mariner's home harbor. Then, the spirits inhabiting the bodies leave, and the crew members collapse, dead. A pilot, his son, and a hermit approach the ship. In the falling action, a whirlpool sinks the mariner's ship, but the mariner is hauled aboard the pilot's boat. The mariner tells the hermit his tale, and he feels better. The mariner tells the wedding guest that the need to tell his tale grows inside him, and that he must find someone to tell it to, or the pain becomes unbearable. In the resolution, the wedding guest goes home to ponder what the mariner told him.